Hey there, simplifiers. We are smack dab in the middle of the most wonderful time of the year, and today I'd like to give you some clutter-free gift ideas. Lists like this have been around for a while. In fact, one of the first newsletters I did when I started my business in 2009 was a Cut the Clutter gift list. But today, not only do I want to give you ideas of clutter-free gifts to give, but the reasons why you may want to request or give these gifts. So the first thing we're going to touch on today is a meal or food gift basket. This basket is great for anybody who likes to cook or bake, or have a family movie night, or maybe even take a romantic picnic if you don't live someplace where it snows in the winter. For instance, you could make an Italian meal gift basket for a family and include pasta and some gourmet pasta sauce and a nice bottle of red wine. Or maybe a family movie night basket with some popcorn and some candy and some sodas, and maybe even include a gift card for someplace like Amazon or Google Play or Apple where they could get a movie online to watch. Or if you've got a family that likes to bake together, you could put together a baking basket with cute cupcake tins and cake mixes and sprinkles, because let's face it, who doesn't love sprinkles? The great thing about giving a meal basket like this is that it shows that you are listening to what this person or this family is interested in. Are they interested in spending family time together, watching a movie and creating memories? Are they passionate about cooking meals at home and would enjoy all the ingredients in one convenient place? The reason the meal basket is on the clutter-free gift list is because most of the things in there are going to be consumable. Therefore, they won't be creating any more clutter in the person's home. So, in lieu of giving somebody who likes cooking more pots and pans or kitchen gadgets, maybe consider buying them great ingredients for a gourmet meal. The next idea on my clutter-free gift list is a subscription. And the great thing about this is there is some sort of a subscription out there for nearly anybody on your list. You could look at something like Netflix or Hulu if the person isn't currently getting those streaming services. Or if they're a music lover, you could look at a music streaming service like Apple Music or Amazon Music or even Napster, which, yes, is still around, and I know because we have it. It's a way that music lovers can get all the music that they want, whenever they want, and pretty much wherever they want. Most services even include the ability to download music, so when you don't want to stream it or use your data to listen to music, you can listen to music right off your phone. And as long as you're still subscribing, you can have that music on your phone. If you want to go for the big daddy of them all subscription services, you could look at something like an Amazon Prime membership for a family member who doesn't currently have it. For that $100, they can get 2-day shipping and access to Amazon Prime Music and Amazon Prime Television. And depending on their geographic location, they may have Amazon restaurants or grocery delivery. It really does provide a lot of conveniences for that $100 subscription fee. And for the kiddos on your list, there's an awesome toy subscription service called Play, P-L-E-Y. It originally started out as a Lego subscription service where you could send off and get a set of Legos sent to you, and then once your kid was done playing with that, you would send it back and get a different one. They've recently expanded and they have all sorts of STEM toys and American Girl dolls that are also available to send to your kiddos. So if you're interested in keeping your toy rotation fresh, rather than adding more and more toys to your collection, you could try a service like Play and have new things sent to you on a regular basis and then send them back when you're done. And finally, if you've got somebody in your life that likes to go to the symphony or see a Broadway play or maybe is really passionate about a local sports team, you could think about a subscription to a symphony season or the Broadway in whatever town you're in series, or even a season subscription to the sports team. Many sports teams now have packages where you don't have to buy every single game, but maybe you get 10 games throughout the season for a more reasonable price than the entire season subscription. Talk to your friends and family about what they're passionate about and see if there's some sort of a subscription that might line up with both what you can afford and what they might enjoy. Next up, we're gonna talk gift cards. And I personally am a big fan of both giving and getting gift cards. For us, we don't get a lot of date nights because we blow all of our babysitter budget every month while we're working. So I would personally love movie and restaurant gift cards as a gift so that all I'm paying for is a babysitter rather than having to also pay for my entertainment if I have a date. And I know that gift cards can sometimes feel like an afterthought or like you didn't really put a lot of effort into the gift. But if you take time to explore what that person likes or needs and then get an appropriate gift card for that person, it may turn out to be better than an actual physical gift that they could open. There is some sort of gift card out there for nearly everything in entertainment or services or shopping or food. So see if you can find one that will line up with the interests of the person that you're buying gifts for. And finally, I want to talk to you today about the idea of donations as gifts. If somebody you know is really passionate about helping animals or hunger or education, go to charitynavigator.com and search around to see if there is a worthy organization that you could donate to. Somebody might ask you to donate in their name to something like this, or you could ask somebody to donate in your name. Find out if there's a charity out there that aligns with something that you personally are passionate about or that the person that you're giving a gift to might be interested in. There are all kinds of organizations that help animals or hunger or education. There's literally a charity out there for nearly everything. I highly recommend going to charitynavigator.org to check out whatever organization you're thinking of donating money to, just so that you know how they distribute the money and what they are rated through Charity Navigator. This is really great if you've got somebody in your life or you yourself are really trying to take a more minimalistic approach to the things in your life. Somebody can really benefit from that $10 or $15 or $25 or $100 donation way more than you would with just more junk that you have to decide where to put and what to do with. Thank you so much for checking out my clutter-free gift ideas today, and I will be back soon with part 2 of my clutter-free gift list. If you have any ideas of things that you like to get or receive that don't create clutter in your house, please comment below and let me know about your ideas. And also, be sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss any of my organizing and simplifying ideas for you and your family. Take care, happy holidays, and I will catch you next time on Organizing with Simple Solutions. If you've got somebody in your life that likes to go to the symphony or see a... Rocky, out!